on the turning away from the pale and downtrodden, and the words they say, which we won't understand. Don't accept that what's happening is just a case of others suffering, or you'll find that you're joining in the turning away.
Thank you. I know who you are.
Landlord.
Dr. Steph, this is Jennifer. I really need you to call me as soon as possible. I need to talk to you. Something happened today, and I need to get in to see you as soon as I can. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Jenny, hello. How are you? It has been a while.
It has been a while. I'm good, but I have been better. There's something that's really been bothering me that I really need to open up to somebody about.
Oh, well, absolutely. Please, go ahead.
You know, I have been working on trying to sell my house,
mm-hmm.
and there's been some issues with that. I had originally thought someone was breaking in and causing some mischief. But when I looked into that, I really think that the problems have to do with a traumatic incident that I went through as a child that I have not opened up to anyone about yet.
Oh, well, Jenny, this is a safe place, and everything that you say here today and any time that you're with me is between us, and I will help any way that I can. So if you feel comfortable, please proceed.
When I was about 12 years old, I had gone on a family vacation with my parents to the Amish country. It was a beautiful day. We were just out relaxing, having a picnic, and I wandered away for a bit, and it's something I have regretted ever since. What happened was I had walked down to some railroad tracks, and there were three kids down there that I thought, oh, well, maybe I can play with them. But it turns out that two of them were picking on another little girl.
Leave me alone!
Now, go call your mom! You're stupid!
No, leave me alone!
You're stupid!
Leave me alone!
You're so stupid and dumb! Go crazy!
Stupid, Sammy! You're so stupid!
I'm sorry. On the turning away from the pale and downtrodden, and the words they say, which we won't understand, don't accept that what's happening is just a case of others suffering, or you'll find that you're joining in the turning away. It's a sin that somehow light is changing to shadow and casting its shroud over all we have known. Unaware how the ranks have grown, driven on by a heart of stone. we could find that we're all alone in the dream of the proud. On the wings of the night, as the daytime is stirring, where the speechless unite in a silent accord. Using words you will find are strange and mesmerized as they light the flame. Feel the new wind of change on the wings of the night. No more turning away from the weak and the weary. No more turning away from the coldness inside. Just a world that we all must share. It's not enough to just stand and stare. Is it only a dream that there'll be no more turning away?